One-third of Australians working from home have said they would start looking for a new job if their employer told them they had to permanently return to the office. New research studying the global shift to working from home found just two other nations more committed to fighting for the flexible arrangement. Watch the video above. One-third of Australians would quit if they couldn't work from home. Watch the latest news on Channel 7 or stream for free on 7 Plus. The National Bureau of Economic Research study found that 35% of Australians working at least one day per week at home would start looking for another job or quit if their employer announced they had to return to their workplace 5 days per week. Of the 27 countries with participants in the Global Survey of Working Arrangements, GSWE, only two countries surpassed this response: Canada, 38%, and the United Kingdom, 42%. The data also found that Australians saw working 2 to 3 days per week at home to be as valuable as a 5.3% pay rise. In all but a few of the surveyed countries, women found working from home more valuable than men, as did people with more education, and married respondents with children under 14. Lead study author Siva Oxoy told 7news.com.au, savings in commute time are perhaps the most obvious and important individual-level benefit of WFH. Daily round-trip commutes average 67 minutes per day in Australia. The COVID pandemic compelled a mass social experiment in working from home, Oxoy told 7news.com.au, generating new information about the working arrangements and greatly shifted perceptions about its practicality and effectiveness. No other episode in modern history involves such a pronounced and widespread shift in working arrangements in such a compressed time frame, the report said. The study looked at full-time workers aged 20 to 59 within two time frames, late July to early August 2021, and late January to early February 2022. Lingering concerns about COVID infection risks, as well as the rise in technology supporting the work-from-home experience, are both noted in the study as having impacted the data. Productivity and office occupancy. Since the pandemic, employers plan an average of one work-from-home day per week for their employees, the report finds, though workers want to make that 2 days on average. The report found that the extent of work-from-home days planned by employers did rise. Over half of respondents felt they were between 10 and 20% more productive while working from home than they expected prior to COVID, with 31% meeting their expectations. Only 13% of respondents felt they were 10 to 20% less productive than they expected. Relative to their pre-pandemic expectations, most Australian workers were surprised to the upside by their WFH productivity during the pandemic. That is, by their own assessments, they were more productive in WFH mode than they had anticipated, Oxoy said. Individuals and organizations re-optimized over working arrangements and moved to a much greater reliance on WFH. A nationwide shortage of workers in Australia is giving them the upper hand to negotiate more flexible work arrangements, professional headhunter from recruiter Robert Half Talent Solutions Nicole Gordon said. Workers want flexibility, where they're able to work from home certain days a week and also go into the office, she told 7 News last month. If they don't offer flexibility, their competitors are, and they're missing out on attracting and retaining their own workforce. The latest Property Council of Australia occupancy survey found office occupancy rates in Sydney and Melbourne have budged only slightly in the last month from 52 to 53% and 38 to 39%, respectively. Adelaide's occupancy rate climbed from 64 to 71% in the last month, Brisbane's occupancy increased from 53 to 57%, and Canberra's from 61 to 64%. Perth was the only market to witness a slight drop from 71 to 69%. And finally, thank you all for watching the video. Please like and comment your opinion so we can discuss together. Don't forget to subscribe. Press the bell to follow and update many other interesting news. See you in the next videos. Goodbye.